Hello friends and hello students. My name is Ashok Sigala. In this session, we learn the HCF, any two integer number in C language using recursion function. So let us start. First, I share my laptop screen and fix the position here so you can watch better where my video lecture. And here, Turbo C++, I double click and take some process. And now yes, is open Alt+F file menu, taking new file, and here our goal, write a program to find HCF of any two positive integer numbers. So, and we can say that using recursion technique or recursion. So recursion means function call itself, that is known as recursion. So let us first in your mind, what is a HCF, or we can say that GCD. Yes, both that is known in maths. So first, that is full for my view. So that is a highest common factor. Yes, that is a factor. So that is highest common HCF, or we can say that greatest. Yes, greatest common divisor. Yes, divisor. So that is a both known as highest common factor or greatest common divisor. So yes, that is, I give one example so you can understand what is this number or how that we have to find out. So here we can, yes, that is a find. So first I give one condition, yes, then we can give example. So first we can say that make the prime, that is make prime factors of the numbers, and then we can say that choose common prime factor. Yes, that is a, we can say that choice, or we can condition. So first we can make prime factor of that number, any two number, and choose common prime factor, and then we can select the, and we can say that then or we can say that and then select HCF, highest common factor. So that is a selection. So now I give one example that you can understand. So we can find HCF 4 and 8. So now we can start. Yes, 4, that is a like prime number. So number itself and one divisor, other is divisor is not possible. So that is a prime number. So here that is a, we all divisor, common divisor. So yes, sir, that is a 4 multiply 1 and 2 multiply 2. So that is, we can get the 4 and 8. So first we can number itself. So 8 multiply 1 and we can say that 4 multiply 2. So that is a, we can get 8, and now 2 multiply 2 multiply 2. So that is also getting 8. So now we can say that factors, yes, factors of 4 is, so we can say that 1, 2, and 4. And factors, yes, factors of 8 is, so we can say that 1, 2, 4, and 8. So now we can, yes, that is a, first make prime factor of that number, yes, prime factor, and choose common factor. So now that is a prime factor of 4, and that is prime factor of 8. Now we can common factor, so separate the common factors, yes, factors of 4 and 8. So that we can say that common factor 4 and 8 is, yes, that is a 1, 2, and 4. And then we can select the highest HCF, that is last step. So here we can say that HCF 4 and 8 is 4. Yes, That is a, here you can look. So first we can find the prime factor of both 4 and 8 number, and then common factor. So 8 is not in the list of 4. So that is a not common. So 1, 2, and 4 is a common. And then highest common factor. So that is a 1, 2, and this list, we can say that 4 is the highest. So now you can understand what is a HCF. So that is a paperwork. So I give that is a multi-comment line. That is your reference. So how that is a find out. And we can also, if user give negative number, so we can convert the positive. So now we can start to our include our header file. Yes, stdio.h. And then on your console input output.h. And then we can declare with argument HCF. Yes, and that return data. So with argument with return data type means that. So that is a UDF user defined HCF. And now we can take as main, and then we can take two integer X and Y. You can declare N1 and N2. That is also possible two numbers. So that is a. And now we can give the message. So here, enter any two integer numbers. So, and also you can give the message, enter any two positive integer number. So here we can convert positive negative number to positive. So let us check how. So we can convert. So first percentage D and percentage T, both number we can scan at the same time. X one scan a function, so X and Y. Now we can convert if user enter negative number, so we can convert in positive. So X is greater than zero, so that meaning X remain X, and otherwise that is a minus X. So minus minus means plus. So if user enter negative, so that convert into positive. Same conditions for Y. Y is greater than zero. Yes, that condition is true. So Y remaining Y, and otherwise negative Y. So I cannot give the message as enter any two positive numbers. Just I enter any two integer number. So if you not write these two lines, so you can give the message enter two positive integer number. Yes. So here I convert that use as a conditional, or that known as a ternary operator in C language. And now we can call our UDF, so user defined function. So we can directly print. Yes, and here I use GCD. Yes, that word of, yes, percentage D. And first we can print two number, and that is, and that percentage D. So that is X and Y. And now I call HCF. So both I cover these words. So here our UDF name is HCF, and here message GCD. So greatest common divisor and highest common factor. So both that known as pronunciation. So X and Y. So that is a calling of UDF, and then get CH. Yes, and that is main is complete. Now definition of our use. So with argument HCF, and now pass two argument. So integer X. Yes, here you can also AB, but here I, or we can use as a N1. Yes, I use N1 and integer N2. And also you can use as a same, no XY. You can also use here I do different variable name. You can also use XY. There is no any problem. So now that if condition here, while loop is not required, because my previous video lecture I take as a first in main and then convert UDF, and that is a very interesting. So here I again that recursion technique. So here we can say that N2 not equal to zero. So we can return, yes, that is a return integer. So yes, return and HCF. So function call itself. So here N2, and then we N1, that is modulo N2. Yes, so that is we can use as a modulo, and otherwise we can return directly N1. So that is a recursion technique. So yes, that very easy and simple way. So function call itself. So here UDF call itself. So not equal to zero, that number of time, that is a call itself. So let us, I first save this file. Just F2 I press, and that is a, we can say that GCD, and that is REC, recursion technique. So dot C, just that save, compile. Yes, there is no any error. So I run, so I give 4 and 8. So yes, 4, that is our perfectly our we can paperwork. So that we can say that perfect our logic. So I give negative, so yes, that converting positive. So -4 and -8, yes, that perfect, same answer. So and user can choose enter positive value or negative, both. So I can convert in, that is ternary or conditional operator in C language. There is 2 lines, very simple logic. And now again, we can take like 6 and 12. So that is a 6 is a greatest common divisor, or we can say that HCF, highest common factor. So now I can give 3 and 15. So that is a 3. So you can enter any number. Yes, and now I can take as a watch window. How that possible? So alter W, yes, and here we can take as a watch. So here that only we can X, yes, and then Y, yes, here I can give, and here N1 and N2. So you can also give X and Y, I previously told you. And alter W, we can take also output window, and now you can know very well, alter R. So that is a trace into F7 function key. I press F7 key, so clear the screen. Yes, you look in our output window, and now scan. So we can scan like 4, yes, and 8. So one blank page is required, because we can scan 2 numbers at same time, and we can also enter and then give second number, that also possibility. So now look at our logic. So that is a if negative, so that converting positive, but here I can positive, so that is remaining same. And now function call itself. So yes, N1 and N2, that is 4 and 8. Now that not 8 is not equal to 0, yes, if condition is true, and that modulo, so 8 means 4 modulo 8. So that is a again, yes, you can look here that number N1 and N2, that is a modulo, and that is again that UDF call. So now that not N1 and N2, yes, that continue process. And now N not equal to but 0, so that is a 4, yes, directly, yes, that is a maintaining the step, first push and pop. Push means insert and pop is delete. So recursion technique, that all first pushing is insert. So take algorithm using the recursion technique. So I think you have to know. And now that you can get our answer. So if you like, I enter the negative number. So let us check. I -3 and -15. So look at how it's work. So here that positive number converting the positive. So look, X is now negative to positive, and same Y. Yes. Now again, call, and that is not 50 is not equal to 0, yes, condition is true. Then we can pass, yes, here reverse. So N2, yes, here Y is assigned to N1 and modulo. So that is a, we can say that like 15, that is 15. So let us check our value, swapping. So N1 is 15, N2 is 3, that is reverse. And now N1 is again not equal to, so again that is, yes, look here, N1 is 3 and N2 is 0. So that is a first push and now return. So again that reverse. So first push, and push means insert in the stack algorithm, and then pop means delete, that means delete. Push in insert, pop is delete in the stack, and recursion technique used as a stack algorithm. So now look, that is a again, and print perfect for output. So that is a very interesting session for your knowledge. So yes, now I complete this session. So yes, write this program to your C notebook if you prepare, And we very interesting and very simple logic, your recursion technique, how HCF or GCD we have to find out. So I hope you can understand. And I close, yes. So now I close this file, alter F3 function key. Yes, I just revise means you can write proper way. So alter F3 function key and then output watch and quit. So any doubt regarding this definition or any concept in C language, so write in comment line. I give the definitely answer to you. Thanks for your watching, supporting and sharing my video lecture, and also subscribe. Yes, that is a very important if you, and also press the bell icon. So I upload my any new video lecture in my YouTube channel, Ashok Sijala Academy. So you can get the one notification from YouTube channel. So that is a you can alert that new video is uploaded by my side. So you can watch and develop your C programming logic. And also my channel, I also tackle C++, ASP.NET, Project in C Sharp, Window Base, and backend tool as access. So I hope so subscribe my channel Ashok Sijala Academy, press the bell icon to never miss any update. Yes, that is my word. So thanks again and Hare Krishna.